wild, wild. Wicked wild, wicked, wicked, wild, wild west. Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider. No, you don't want nada, none of this. Six gunning this, brother running this. Buffalo soldier, look, it's like I told you. Any damsel that's in distress, be out of that dress when she meet Jim West.
Episode 18, the podcast officially legal.
Fuck yeah.
Oh my god, barely legal.
You think it's legal?
It's barely legal.
Would you?
This podcast just turned 18. Would I fuck this podcast? Yes. Yeah.
You would fuck it?
Yeah.
This is definitely a guy podcast, dude.
I'd have to.
You're gay.
So what?
You're gay now.
I can't help. This podcast, if this was a man, I'd go gay and fuck it.
If you go gay, you're going to be able to get into a lot of festivals.
That's true. My comedy career would fucking blast off the fucking ground.
How is everyone? How are you, Matthew?
Good. Doing good.
Doing all right. I haven't seen you in a while. I got snowed in.
Yeah, you're up. You're up there in the north.
Mechanicsburg.
Damn, dude.
Whew.
Did you guys get a lot of snow?
Yeah, more. It looks like we got a lot more.
Yeah, we
didn't
get that much here. It was just fucking ice.
Yeah.
We got crushed with ice. It was cool.
Yeah.
Last night, I was happy. Last night, I was on stage. My hair kept falling in my eyes. Dude, I kept loving pulling it out.
Yeah, for our listeners, Matt's hair is flowing.
It's getting long.
Looks good.
I just talked about being a true artist the whole time, pushing hair out of my eyes.
You do look like an artist right now.
It was sick.
You look terrible.
It's all about image, dude.
Stand up real quick. I want to see that sweatsuit. Matt's wearing a tucked-in sweatsuit. He's got a crew neck hoodie. Or not a hoodie, excuse me. A crew neck tucked into red sweatpants.
Hell yeah. Tight reds, baby.
That's literally the Down syndrome uniform. That's what you're wearing.
It's gym day.
Dude, if I wore that outfit, people would help me. Everywhere I went, people would hand me things and help me. And you just look like a fucking maniac in that.
It's gym day, dude. like someone's schizophrenic uncle.
You do.
Yeah.
They get big, though. Schizophrenics get big.
Do they really?
Yeah, they get fat.
A lot of, I think like 95% of schizophrenics smoke cigarettes.
Yeah, they don't, yeah.
They love sure. cigs. It's fucking
they
sweet.
They do not give a I worked for the state, and I went into this one house that was a house for schizophrenic men.
Oh.
Phew, that was rough.
It's got to be a nightmare.
They did smoke their fucking dicks
They don't
off,
stop,
though.
Yeah.
But they also don't care about themselves.
Yeah.
It's weird. Like, they were all fat as fuck. They were all in shitty sweatsuits.
Holy fuck.
Just covered in stains and shit, just walking around.
Holy shit.
Yeah, they were nuts. I mean, literally.
Dude,
it's probably not the right thing to say about
it. I watched a documentary. It was about, like, a place like that for to treat people. It was in, central Pennsylvania. It was in the 80s. So there's just, like, a dudes in, like, Miami Dolphin sweatpants tackling fucking schizophrenics. I'm like, dude, fucking chill.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's what my job was. Yeah. I had to go
You were an orderly?
No. I had to go, if there was an incident,
yeah.
I had to go investigate the incident and find out if the orderly was wrong or not.
Holy
so,
fuck.
So, like, we'd watch security footage of these dudes just spearing retarded guys. Just Terry Tate off his linebackering a bunch of retarded guys around the house.
In the documentary, the one dude is schizophrenic and like has like a mild case of Down syndrome. So he was like the guy's the
I don't
doctor.
Know if you, do you have mild Downs?
Me?
No, I mean.
No, I think he. This I don't know. Yeah, good question.
It seems like mild AIDS.
Either you have it or you don't. Yeah. But that's what this guy said. He was like, well, he's schizophrenic and he has like mild. He said mental retardation. And okay. The guy's like, what? And he's like, you're a little retarded. And he's like, anyway. And he kept talking. And the
yeah,
guy was
you showed
dude,
me this.
It was so funny.
Weren't they sitting next to each other?
Yeah,
at the
right next to
yeah,
each
yeah,
other.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm what? He's like, you're retarded. And he was like, okay.
It was so fucking funny. Yeah, that was definitely the most depressing job I've ever had.
That had to have been insane.
Well, it wasn't. We usually didn't deal with adults. It was usually kids.
See, that's just as bad, if not worse. Yeah.
Especially because it was like juvenile, like detention centers and shit.
Yeah, this guy cried because he put his head like near the window and the sun beamed on his head and he like for like 2 days was like the sun hit my head and like freaked the fuck out.
Oh,
dude, like Jesus. How do you even talk someone down from that? It's like yeah. I don't know, bud.
I think
swallow these things and just go to bed for a while.
My first day, someone killed themselves. A kid killed themselves.
Good Lord,
himself, and we had to go. Yeah, never mind.
Yeah.
And we had to investigate that.
Yeah,
that was rough.
Holy fuck.
And then my last day, I got fired.
You got fired from the nut house?
I did not give a fuck about this job.
You're like a young Ken Kesey.
And I got fired. And the last day, like when I was like leaving, they were like, oh, we have to go to Pittsburgh. I was like, why? They were like, two of the kids beat another kid to death with a vacuum cleaner. And I was like, all right, I'm going home.
Perfect.
Jesus Christ, I'm going home.
Fuck.
Yeah, that was miserable, man. Oh. But I was in an office of all ladies, and they fucking hated me, dude.
Of course.
They hated me, and there was one other dude, and he was like, he played the game. He was like their fucking, like they all loved him. They thought he was the hottest guy in the world. He was just this like volleyball player.
That's so funny.
He sucks dick, dude. I saw through all his little gay fucking game. He flirted with every chick there. Like the one chick was like, we're like office husband and wife. You're my office husband.
Ew.
And I was like, dude, if your fucking husband found out about that, he'd beat that guy to death with a fucking vacuum.
Oh, it's so fucking funny. Yeah, they didn't like that at all, did they?
They didn't like my attitude.
Oh, my God.
I just sat there. Oh, yeah, and they didn't have a desk for me, so I had the secretary's desk at just the front of the office.
Oh.
This fucking lady recorded how long my lunches were.
The fuck?
It was like 35 minutes instead of 30.
Did they know your sister?
No.
I was going to say, there's a chance they just didn't like your sister.
No, they didn't know my sister, and they didn't know the power that my sister had. And they didn't know that I was late every day because I was riding in with my sister.
Yeah.
Who could be late. And I never told my sister I was getting in trouble for being
late. Yeah, you told me that. Then you got fired for being late.
I got fired for being late. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I was like 5 minutes late at the most every day. I hate that so much.
And what you're dealing with. Yeah. It's like, dude, give you a couple minutes.
Let's go investigate a child's suicide. Also, you're 3 minutes late and your lunch was 4 minutes long.
That's insanity.
We're going to have to write you up. I was like, all right, write me up. Yeah, what happens?
Please.
What happens if you write me up? Well, we just have it written down. I'm just like, all right.
I tried to quit one time a job, and they just were like, no. I would fantasize all day in this cold calling place about getting fired.
Oh, cold calling sucks.
Dude, the one lady came in. It was the owner's sister, and I fucking hated this lady. She came in, and she was like, I forget what I've been. She wanted me to do this like bullshit fucking task of like going through all these envelopes and opening up letters and reading them. I was just like, I'm not doing that. Straight up Bartleby, like, no. I'd prefer not to.
Bartleby?
Yeah, it was Bartleby the Scrivener. It was like a short story you had to read in college about a guy. Okay. The guy came up and he was like, Bartleby, can you do this? And he's like, I'd prefer not to. And the guy's like, I don't know what to do with this fucking guy. So I Bartleby this lady, and I was like, I'm not doing that. I was like, I just refuse. She was like, you can't refuse. I'm like, please. I literally told this. It was like my boss. I was like, I fantasize all day about getting fired. Like, fire me.
Yeah, man. Some places won't fire you. If you want to get fired, they will not fire you.
And that put a bad thing, because then when I was at the dog walking place, I figured I could fucking show my hand there, and instantly fired me. And I was fuck.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I was like, oh, we'll get the fuck out.
So I worked when I sold cars right out of high school.
Yeah.
I was pretty obviously quitting. Like, the whole time I was there, that place, that was great. Like, you could show up late as fuck. Yeah. If you sold a car, you could pretty much just, I would just leave every day. I did not give a fuck. I could not believe they kept me. They kept me. I quit. Yeah. I ended up leaving. And then the job I had here at Ardmore.
Mm-hmm.
They kept me.
Oh, that was insane.
That was crazy.
You think I'd go sit in my car for like a half an hour?
I would just leave every day. I also would show up like 3 hours late every single day. They're like, try to be here at 8. I would walk in at 10 and be like, this is pretty good. I'd be like, all right. They kept me again.
Dude, that's so funny.
But yeah, I don't think I can have a job.
No.
I'm certain. I'm going to need one.
But yeah.
Good Lord.
I can work for like 3 days at a time, and then it'll get to the point where I'll be like standing at a job like, I got to get the fuck out of here.
At least you're doing like manual shit.
Which is nice.
I've done that. Even then, I still showed up pretty fucking late every time.
Yeah. Though that's another place. They might, sometimes places like that will tolerate it. If you can get shit, if they know you'll get something done. But I just like the like just not thinking. If I am at a job, I don't want to think, and I don't want to deal with anyone.
Yeah. Well, enough job stuff.
Yeah, enough monster.com.
No one gives a fuck.
Not at all. Dude.
All these people are stuck in their mindless dog shit jobs.
I know. Caught in the fucking labyrinth.
You and me are doing it right, dude. Long free. Hair, sweatsuit.
Long hair, sweatsuits. I've been farting horribly for 3 days.
That's perfect. It's so I got bad. Home right when I walked in. Matt was waking up from a nap off his air mattress. This is the life, dude.
I took a headphone nap at like 2:30. I don't even know what time it is right now.
I got to move my car at 7, so we're good.
Yeah, you're good. We're good for now. Time. Dude, last night, typical fucking showbiz clashing with the networks.
Oh, yeah?
Already got a taste of it, dude. Jesus Christ. The Oxygen.
Oxygen? The Oxygen
Network. Yeah, the Oxygen Network. Big Oxygen Network came through. So our friends do stand-up, Charles Blizzick and Sarah Bell, and they're throwing a showcase at Fergie's. And the Oxygen Network, which, I'll credit Chris Wood. I think he's onto something. There was like a weird conspiracy there where like the Oxygen Network just happened to be there being like, oh, we had no idea anything was going on. And they had a show called, Bliznik was calling it Lesbian Wife Swap. And I thought he was serious. So I called it Lesbian Wife Swap. And a producer came up. He's like, it's not Lesbian Wife Swap. It's called Switching Teams. Where like, it's like Wife Swap, but for like a gay male couple and lesbians. And then they swap.
Oh, God.
Yeah. And, you know, whatever.
Why the fuck would they do that?
I mean, why wouldn't they? For Oxygen Network, it's like...
Yeah, but that's like the two things they definitely hate. Like, if I'm a gay dude, I don't like women, and I don't like men's personalities. And that's exactly what a lesbian is.
Yeah.
She's probably like, let's watch the ball game. And he's like, oh my God.
Probably both end up killing each other.
He can't even jerk him off. So what happened?
Oh my God. So it was just like these... Just a crew of fucking just weirdo. The one dude...
Yeah, of course.
The one cameraman looked just like one of the fucking guys from 300, like the bad guys.
Oh, Persian?
The Persians, yeah. He looked like a 300... he looked like a big gay Persian. He was the guy who corrected me. It wasn't called Lesbian Wife Swap. And then there was a lady...
What's it actually called?
Switching Teams.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Sorry.
And there was a lady in a red leather like leotard who was going to play like a song for all of us, apparently. So this whole, you know, they're like, we'll film your guys' sets and maybe we'll like work them in and they'll get on, blah, blah, blah. It's like, whatever. And the audience was like six gay black dudes came in like to be on. There it was just pure just moonlights, dude.
Holy shit.
It was just like six moonlights came in.
Damn. Six moonlights in the front?
Yeah. And they wouldn't, like they were enjoying. No,
I'm sure you could relate to them on a ton of subjects.
I was excited to go on. But yeah, it was literally like just them sitting there. At a joke, like they would laugh, but only like, you know, when someone recognizes that it's been a punchline and they go like, oh, ha 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 ha, and they'd be like, yes, and it was just like nonstop yeses,
oh, God.
Nonstop chatter amongst themselves, and it was like,
just told them Beyonce sucks,
dude. See what happens. I wanted to go up so fucking bad, and then so like, you know, a couple comics go up there, you're getting loud, and then you know, Sarah's like, hey, can you guys like just chill out while one of the comics on stage, and she was like, oh no, and it turned into this big thing. There's cameras.
Of course,
there
was drama.
Dude, it was, yeah, exactly. And Brandon Vincent Jackson, before any of this happened, was like, is that six gay black dudes? He's like, this is going to explode.
By the way, he is a gay black
dude. He's a gay black dude, which, yeah, yeah. Sorry. But yeah, he called it, dude, and it literally erupted into, like, the show got stopped dead in the tracks. At one point, the girl in the red leotard crashed the stage and was like, I'm going to play my song now. Sarah's like, get the fuck off the stage. And, like, dude, the whole time the cameras are going.
Oh,
the gay black dude, the moonlights are trying to fight people, dude. It was so funny.
That's not going
to
be a good look for Sarah.
They're gonna chop that up hard, dude.
Yeah, they're gonna chop that up to dude. Be like, look at us getting
and
impressed.
Then, and yeah, dude, and that's what happened. At one point, Sarah was like, well, you know, I don't know. She like went between comedians and like tried to say like, I don't know if you guys, you know, a lot of people haven't been to a lot of comedy shows, and they're like, oh, okay, we see what you're saying. And she was like, no, like, dude, it was pure reality. It was
fuck.
I was in an episode of reality TV, like the shit I used to watch when I was married. And be like, I hope people don't start acting like this. It was
You were in there flipping tables.
Yeah,
you were one of them.
Yeah. I was like, yes,
no, bitch. And he was like,
I was just, I had a glass of Chardonnay. I was trying to throw it on the moonlight scene. I was like,
throw it on the moonlight. Damn, dude, they probably got you for a confessional after.
Oh,
this
dude
sitting down in front of the camera, like, I could not believe Devante told me this.
I mean, did you even see his shirt, dude? I was sitting there the whole time. I just watched it silently and just watched this. Thing escalate and go down.
And then they show one of their confessions. It's like, and then a schizophrenic man in a sweatsuit assaulted us with Chardonnay. You're like, get out of here, moonlight star.
Dude, then the last producer came. One of the guys went up while the camera's rolling and hugged Sarah, like photo ops. So they're going to chop it up like comedy show. The lady's like, can I play? Let me get on stage. And Sarah, like, get the fuck off stage. And then, like, a guy, like, hugging her, like, it's okay. And the girl's like, I just play about peace and love. It was so obviously, like,
holy fuck.
It was insanity.
God damn, so I wish I was there for
dude,
that.
Motherfucker. It was insane. And then the producer was the last one trying to, like, argue with everyone, like, that could have been real good for you guys. It could have been real good for y'all. You know, I could have put you on. And then as he was walking out, I was like,
Network.
I was like, dude, it's the Oxygen Network. No one gives a fuck. And he's like, I know people at Comedy Central. And I was like, all right, man, still. No one gives a fuck. And he was like, this dude was so fucking mad. He was so mad. And he's like, and he started, I'm like, all right, dude, you can have
the
last word.
Was that the Persian?
It wasn't the Persian. The Persian left.
I was
going to
say, dude, you 300 them.
He
did 300 them.
They're like, we're leaving. But they got what they needed, so.
Yeah.
Dude, it was fucking nuts. And then, like, it was like, the guy went up and sat behind. He, like, sat in another chair. He's like, I'm going to let someone else say something. We'll see what happens. It was, like, full on, like, just. Reality TV
chaos in there.
About to fight. It was so funny.
Fuck.
It's the best.
It was actually, Irish people.
It was horrible. No. So then, and this is so then these Irish people wandered in afterwards for the open mic, and were just fucking the whole time, just yelling shit out.
Irish people are the worst.
Actually, no, they were there the whole time. They saw that whole thing. They saw that. I'm sorry.
Oh my god.
Because they were there for my set, so they saw that whole thing. No. I take that back. I was after that, so they weren't there for that whole thing.
Okay. Sorry. So you weren't on.
I wasn't on. I wanted to go on. It was going to be Brandon, then me, and then it just blew up. And then Brandon went on, and I went on. There's these two Irish people there, and I kept making fun of them just for like living in like a fucking Braveheart village and like, well, you guys sound like you have a fucking sock in your mouth. Anything they said, I'd just be like, I don't understand you guys. Tell them that like celiacs came from Ireland. It's like their version of AIDS they brought to the United States. It was so fun. And then like,
you should have told them about your cousin's website idea or your brother's.
Oh, Irish or retarded?
Irish or retarded.com.
Irish or retarded.com.
It's a hell of a website, dude. You,
my my brother Tom has a website. I should
post that picture of my dad's basketball picture. Irish or retarded.
My brother wants to start a website where you just scroll through kind of like Faces of Meth, where it's just Irish people and retarded people, and you got to guess if they're Irish or retarded. That's the best.
Irish or retarded is fucking hilarious.
But yeah, it was funny, man. It was funny watching people try to attack the Irish, and it was like, you can't, dude. You
can't get them.
She went up and hugged one of the comics, and the one comic took it as like, it was like, are you assaulting me? And they were just like, what the fuck is going on? It was so fucking funny. And then at one point,
what the fucking the lady, shit show.
The Irish lady at one point, like, I was like talking to her. I was like, I bought them, because I was fucking with them so much, I bought them each a drink. And then the lady's like, tie my shoe. And like, she put her boot up to me, and like instinctively I was like, okay. And just started like tying her shoe. She's like, what the fuck are you doing? Get off my foot. She's like, I usually don't wear shoelaces. And I was like, why? And she's like, because black people will steal your shoes. And I was like, what? What? What the fuck are you talking about? And I was like, oh, fuck. I forgot what you guys love to do. Black people will steal your shoes. I was like, what the fuck?
That's fucking great.
Dude, I was telling Cindy about it, too. I was like, as he was talking about them, I'm like, dude, I forgot just how, like, funly racist Irish people are. Because it doesn't sound vicious. It's just, you're just like, all right, man, yeah,
they'll
sure.
get your shoes.
They'll get your shoes from you. You got to watch them.
It's like, what? Like a fucking fairy tale.
You know, fucking little leprechauns, dude. But yeah, that was fun. That was a good time. O2, dude, shut down the oxygen network.
Yeah, nice, man.
Dude, I wanted to chase him out and be like, dude, put me on. I'll suck a dick to get on oxygen.
Fuck that. That sucks. You guys, did you sign anything?
I didn't sign shit.
I wonder if Sarah did.
Yeah, she did.
Oh,
she signed a release. She signed a release. Well, they told us, they were like, we're going to use like your, I would have totally signed something if they came up to me. They're like, we might throw your stand-up clips on oxygen to like cut in and out of the show. So fuck that's that. How I think they baited them.
What would that get you?
Nothing. That's what, I was just laughing at the whole thing. I was just like, dude, this is ridiculous.
Yeah, here's 10 psycho fans now. If that.
If no, who's 10 people are going to hate your, or yeah. definitely going to hate my stand-up.
Yeah.
The Oxygen Network on a show about a gay couple wife swap. They're going to be like, yeah, fuck that guy.
Yeah.
They wouldn't. It wouldn't even have been material. It'd
your
just
your
like,
caption in the confession would be like retarded comedian, Matt McCusker, retarded comedian, screaming moonlight and throwing drinks at black people, dude. That's not a good look.
I didn't throw a drink.
You said you tried to throw some Chardonnay during
that's
the scuffle.
That's the classic fucking reality show move. Just like bitch and like throw a fucking glass of Chardonnay.
That's yeah, what I was. Do. I actually watched some reality TV. I watched the finale of The Bachelor.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Do you know a lot of those girls go in debt from being on that show?
No.
The contestants don't get paid.
They get a ton of money afterwards.
Dude, I read they if they win. If they don't win, like those the initial round of ladies, no, they buy like a, they don't get paid.
They. I don't know about that. Where'd you read that?
On the internet.
Yeah, I don't know. I know a lot of them got rich because now they all do like Instagram modeling and like they sell products and shit.
Certain ones can do that, but like if they don't turn it around for
sure
themselves.
How do they lose? How do they go in debt?
It's just a chance. Cause, so they take off of work. A lot of them take off of work for like 2 or 3 months.
None of them have real jobs. They're all like fucking gymnasts.
Yeah, well, they buy clothes. They got to buy a bunch of, they get 2 dresses supplied by the studio, but like they need like a zillion outfits and they're on TV. A girl on TV is going to spend fucking thousands of dollars.
I doubt travel would not be covered.
Travel's probably covered, but it's just one thing. I was reading on the internet, dude. They said like a bunch of them went in debt.
Oh, good. Fuck them. I hope they are.
Yeah, I mean, someone's dad just being like, oh, God damn it.
Yeah, I paid for my baby to fly out to Malibu to get banged by Nick or some guy.
Get banged by some dude who definitely has herpes.
The guy on this he's the worst.
Really?
It's fucking
unbelievable. You're telling me he's like, I had a good time with you. But like.
It's crazy. And like, he proposes to the winner,
mm-hmm.
which is insanity.
Yeah.
But, so he's down to two. They're in like fucking Norway, which is where they had one scene where he goes on two dates right before he proposes. The one was like him like ice skating with this chick and like just clearly for the cameras.
Yeah, of course.
Everything they did was for the cameras.
Yeah.
Like he like held her and like he tried to be so romantic.
Dude.
And then like when they would leave, he would like just stare at the fire and they would like show him just looking at the fire like, oh man. He's like, my heart, I don't know what my heart's telling me to do.
Oh, my God.
And then so he brings the girl, the first girl in that he dumps. He brings her and he's like, my heart's just like, it's like I woke up this morning and I knew, like, I love you, but I could never be in love with you.
Ugh.
It's fucking crazy. And the girls on the show are just like, oh, my God. They all just eat that shit up.
Ugh.
Yeah, it was terrible.
It's crazy.
It was terrible. So I watched, that was a 3-hour episode.
What?
I didn't watch
that. But it was 3 hours long?
At 10, it started at 8, it ended at 11. So holy, it was like a 2-hour episode and then a 1 hour after the show. Yeah, man.
Dan, that's millions. That's a highly rated TV show, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's
every fucking
15 million people tuning
retard in a sweatsuit's watching that shit.
Fuck, man. I'm glad I have the sweatsuit disease. It doesn't involve fucking watching that shit.
You have an interesting sweatsuit disease.
I do.
I have a sweatsuit and video game disease. I toss a sweatsuit. Dude, what do you think I've been doing since fucking Sunday?
I know.
I went to the gym once, maybe twice.
Yeah.
Other than that.
Yeah, the PlayStation's gone. So now Xbox. You disappeared behind that PlayStation, yeah. Dude. You went out in a poof of smoke.
Yeah. Our fucking PlayStation left with our one roommate. So now we have an N64. I got Mario Kart, dude. I'm going to get so good at that.
I'm just going to come in here. Fucking banana peels.
Yeah, I did that.
Oh my God.
I can't be home that long.
Yeah.
That's way too long.
You start getting sucked
in. There's nothing to do.
You started getting fucking,
No, I was not complacent at all there.
No, I'm saying you started probably getting, you know what, in the sunken place, dude. Oh, those white people. You probably got in the sunken place.
Well, it's weird too, because Caitlin is like totally, my girlfriend like totally is cool with me doing nothing all day.
That's kind of nice.
It's rare. Kind of nice.
It's rare.
I feel guilty about it, and then she'll come home and be like, what'd you do today? I'll be like, I'm fucking... Nothing. I woke up like 3 hours ago. Because she goes to school.
Yeah, yeah.
She gets home at like 3.
And she doesn't...
I'll wake up at like noon.
She throws you no shade?
None.
What?
Yeah, I can't believe it.
Dude, when I was married, I used to have to get... If I didn't have to work, I still would get out of bed the same time as my ex. Mad. And just walk around like I was doing stuff, and then I'd go lay down. Because like if I laid in bed, it was just like I'd hear shit slamming and dropping.
My mom resents my dad every time because she was a teacher, and my dad was a salesman from like basically from at home.
Yeah.
So he would wake up whenever.
Yeah.
She would always get... She always was mad. Oh, the woodman's coming in.
Oh, nice.
Take a break?
Yeah, a little breaker.
All right.
And we're back.
Yeah, we're back. Anyway, my mom would get mad at my dad for sleeping in.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Moral of the story. Girls are fucking gay.
So this is one thing that kept me going during the blizzard. So you remember Shia LaBeouf's thing about he will not divide us?
Oh, yeah. Putting the camera where people can come up and be
Yeah. So a bunch of guys, there's a thing on Reddit where they're like alt-right, like Nazi... Well, I think they're just trolling.
Yeah.
But they like constantly are like, Hitler did nothing wrong. Like whenever, like that's their like grabbing by the pussy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like they would sneak up to that camera.
Yeah.
And be like, Hitler did nothing wrong. And it got so bad that Shia LaBeouf actually like assaulted one of them and got arrested. And they also, they call themselves Kekistan.
Like I've heard, I have heard of that. Shia LaBeouf infiltrate Kekistan?
No, they infiltrated him. So they fucked with him. So he put up that He Will Not Divide Us thing. For those of you who don't know, He Will Not Divide Us is this like art installation that he put up outside of a art museum in New York where apparently people were just going to say He Will Not Divide Us on just repeat that
Yeah. And the you're supposed to go up with like a, like it's better to go up with like a different, like if you're white, get like an Asian friend and like go up and hug.
Yeah.
Like,
if you're white, get in the back. Yeah. Unless you're a lady. And you don't know your role, then get in the front. If you're a white lady, if you're a white lady, you're like, I'm a victim too. Shut up.
Yeah. Nah. It's like, yeah.
So anyway, they found that and they ruined it. And so the place shut it down. Oh,
they ruined the tape? They ruined the camera?
Yeah, they shut it down. So then Shia LaBeouf moved it to New Mexico, and they ruined it there. They did the same thing, ruined it there. So then he fucking set up a live stream of a flag, just a white flag, that he angled it so the camera was only facing the flag and the sky.
Yeah.
And said, this flag will fly for the duration of Trump's presidency on this live feed. So it's a live feed of a white flag that says he will not divide us, but all you can see is the sky.
So people can't like fuck with it.
Yeah. So you can't find it. This is how crazy these guys are. They started studying flight plans and flight patterns from the planes in the distance.
Holy fuck.
They're like,
fuck.
If a plane's crossing right now, we need to check the patterns. And they were judging by weather and night and then fucking bird formations. And they found it took 37 hours.
Stop.
Swear to God.
And these are just laymen. These are just guys on the internet who are kind of smart.
Like, no, this is like the dark. Like their whole thing is like never underestimate the power of autism. Like they're fucking. They kept fucking with Shia LaBeouf. But the way they did it was they found out that it was in Tennessee based on everything. And then they had people drive around and beep horns till somebody heard it on the live feed.
Holy fuck.
And they were like, holy fuck, we heard it. Then they fucking waited till nightfall, took the flag down, and put a Trump hat up. How fucking crazy is that?
Holy shit.
This guy tried to film just a flag in the sky in the background.
And they found it.
Based off the fucking planes and like birds.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, in 36 hours.
That's insanity.
Yeah.
It's so funny that Shia LaBeouf right now is just like fighting internet Reddit trolls.
He's getting fucking destroyed.
Of course
dude.
He is.
He's getting destroyed.
Dude, those guys like.
They got him arrested. They fucking stole his flag. They fucking. Trump had so funny.
Him like in the morning, like snapping on his like leather bracelets and like checking his live feed and seeing the hat. He must have been like, God fucking damn it.
Holy fuck, dude. Fuck. I could not believe it.
Getting your live feed trolled.
The flight patterns is insane.
I would have never. I couldn't
figure
that.
Two planes crossing in the background.
That's like CIA level.
Well, yeah,
shit.
And then apparently that same group is they've gotten ISIS people killed. So like ISIS will release a video, and these fucking psychos will be like, all right, based on this, this, and this,
holy
this is where they are.
Fuck.
And we'll blow it up.
What?
Yeah.
Holy shit,
yeah,
dude.
These guys are fucking great. Other than the whole, like, swastikas and...
Yeah, I mean...
White supremacy thing.
That's pretty bad.
They're pretty fucking funny. Again, yeah. I don't think they're really, like... I think they're honestly just doing
just
that.
Just fucking with them, yeah.
To constantly troll everyone.
Holy shit.
But, yeah, that's...
That is wild.
That made me happy.
Yeah.
It was... I watched, like, an hour of YouTube videos on that.
So, LaBeouf now is facing assault charges?
Well, he got that from the one in New York, yeah.
Yeah. And now, what's his next live feed?
I don't know if he can. It's got to be indoors.
They'll hack it. Like they'll have someone hack it. They'll get to it somehow.
I don't know,
dude.
The fact that they found it off of just the sky was fucking wild.
It's terrifying.
Yeah.
Fuck. I hope I never piss a bunch of internet trolls off.
I don't think you will.
I don't know, dude.
I think they're gonna like you.
No,
I
they
think
don't.
Those guys would like you.
I think they would too, actually.
Although you did just get booted off Reddit, right?
I got booted off the conspiracy board.
Why?
Fucking telling the truth about Trump snorting Keef, dude.
They booted you off?
There was actual guys like, you have to decarboxylate Keef in an oven in order for me to bioavailable, and someone just came along and was like, this is bullshit, and fucking trashed me.
Wait, you got fucking kicked off for having a bad conspiracy?
I basically fared. I shared a fake article. Of my own design.
You wrote the article?
Yeah, totally.
Oh.
So I faked news and I got kicked off.
In a conspiracy board,
that's
though?
What I'm saying, dude. Like, it could be
it's
true.
It's all fake news.
Exactly. It could be true. But they booted me, dude. And if I attempt...
Were you talking shit?
I said nothing. I just posted it. I didn't say anything. That was the other one when I got booted out of fucking Skyrim.
Booted out of Skyrim?
Yeah, because they get video game.
Yeah.
Because when I first made it, I thought you needed a lot of karma to like get your stuff on the internet. On Reddit.
Okay.
So I knew our old roommate, Crick, used to play Skyrim.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, I watch him play it. I can just chat these guys up and get points. And I was like, yo, my one roommate plays the, he doesn't play the multiplayer version. He plays just like the single version. He's a fucking pussy. And then everyone, dude, it was the only time anything's like, ever blown up.
There's no multiplayer.
Yeah, they're like, there is no multiplayer. What the fuck are you talking about? And I was like, huh? And they're like, you're thinking of Elder Scrolls, which is blah, blah, blah. And I was like, all right, like, calm down, you fucking virgins. And then it was just like, oh, dude.
Well, don't say that. Dude.
Blah, blah, blah. I got destroyed. Boof,
dude.
I got destroyed. And then they were just, I ended up with like negative 35 karma the first day. I was like, fuck. I couldn't post until I got it back up to one.
I love when you get these ideas to like fuck with shit and you just get destroyed
every time, dude.
Dude, the Street Fighter thing at night is so funny. I know we already said this, but dude, yeah. The idea of you, so Matt was in a failing marriage. He thought the one thing that would make him happy was this, this cell phone game where he played online and fought people and he went 0 in like 80. He just got his ass kicked before bed every night.
Every night, I'd come home and just get like in like a weird, vague argument and be like, fuck this, and lay down and start playing. She'd be like, go to sleep. I'm like, I'm going to go on my phone, all right? Shut up. Then I just like get my balls beaten off by an 8-year-old Chinese kid. Just put my phone down and just be like, go to bed.
Oh, we got to do shout-outs, dude.
Dude, you know who's getting a big one right now?
Who?
Motherfucking Pat George. What's up, boy?
Dude.
Share Pat Monster, George. Dude. Share in the good cast.
Pat George is the man.
Share Monster.
He's a good dude.
Great boy.
Who'd you Andrew, got? Andrew Mahone.
Mm.
Yo, shout out fucking Pug and Truth, dude. You know who he is.
Hell yeah.
Ben Marr?
Yeah, check him in there.
How do you say his last name?
Marr, maybe. Bill Marr. Ben Marr.
Marr. M-A-H-E-R. Mayor.
Mayor. Marr. It's Marr. I think it's all Ben right, Marr.
Whatever. My cousin Pat.
Pat.
Pat's the bull, dude.
What's up, baby? We Bobby McCusker. I'll chuck Bobby in there.
Oh, yeah?
He was the one calling you a white pussy.
Fuck that guy. Bobby, you fucking bitch. I'm a white pussy. What's Bobby do?
He does hardscaping.
Oh, yeah. You told me.
Yeah,
this.
Yeah.
I've done that job. It's for fucking retards. It's for people who carry blocks. You're just human fucking Tetris, dude. Kill yourself. Kate. I got to shout out Kate and Mina.
Hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah.
My sister and brother-in-law.
Definitely.
My Egyptian brother-in-law.
Definitely.
What's going on? Never shouted them off. No,
you didn't at all. Yeah, no. They've listened to a lot of the
episodes. They just complained at dinner.
Well.
They're like, you never gave us a shout out. I was like, all right.
Well, you did shout them out technically on the podcast from Baller
Block. I talked about them a couple times.
From Baller Block and me to the beach, dude. I
remember
that.
True. But yeah, when I said that, I said I've shouted you out before. They're like, all you do is make fun of Katie for being jacked. Mina for being Arab. I said, well.
Oh, shout out to fucking shout out.
Also, shout out Nick Oldershaw, dude.
Ooh.
You remember that boy?
Who's that boy?
He's the kid who seems gay. He's from Baltimore now. He's out in L.A. He did HMAC with us.
It's like every comic I meet. Yeah, oh, I yeah.
Yeah. He's the fucking man.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
He is one of the least. He gives the worst first impressions of anybody I think I've ever
really?
Met. First time I met him, I wanted to fucking fight him.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Immediately, I wanted to fight him.
Yeah.
Turns out he's great.
Yeah, he's pretty cool. He seemed cool to me.
Yeah, and he's really funny.
Fuck
yeah. He's a funny fucking guy.
He's out in L.A. now?
He's out in L.A. He actually texted me because he was surprised we didn't shit on Amy Schumer's special.
I didn't even see it.
It's terrible, but...
Did you hear what happened with that one, too?
What, the alt-right?
Well, that's what they're saying. Everyone's saying it's the alt-right, but apparently it just got
it's
like...
It's bad.
Yeah, and apparently that's what someone was like. It wasn't just... There was dudes from the alt-right like, yeah, fuck off. But apparently it got like... 900 one-star reviews.
It was one. It's like averaging like a little over
one
star.
Half,
yeah. I watched it. It's terrible.
Of course. Yeah.
It's really bad. But the way those guys go about it, it's like, look at this fucking fat pig.
Fat whale. I think they called her a whale. Which only just boosts her up.
Did you see her fucking Instagram post that was like, I will be a powerful voice?
Yes,
like,
I saw that.
It's like, no, your special suck dick.
Yeah, that's the thing.
You're not a powerful voice.
Yeah. Or you are. You're a celebrity, you know, whatever, but...
But yeah,
dude,
I think that was a little harsh on Nick. Nick's the fucking man.
Yeah, hell yeah. No, it's not
I
harsh on him.
Stand by the fucking terrible first impressions.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It was me, him, and Crick at Magoobies. That was the first time I met him.
Okay.
And he, like, I don't think he knew I could do stand-up or was good at it. Mm-hmm. He probably thought I was just a fucking dipshit. Mm-hmm. So, like, I sat down. It was me, him, and Crick, and he, like, only talked to Crick. I mean, he only knew Crick, really, but he didn't give me any respect.
Yeah.
Know? So then I did well, and since then he's liked me.
That's funny.
Which is good.
That's how it goes. Yeah, exactly. That's how it goes. No, it definitely is.
There's 9 to 1 fucking weird dipshits in this in comedy.
Dude, not even weird.
It's 9 to 10 or what the fuck? 9 to 1 Yeah, that's fair. It's fucking about 90% fucking weird.
It's literally psychos. You thought you left the nut house, dude. You didn't. You're still in there.
You and me are the fucking good ones.
Sweatsuits,
wolf t-shirts, dip.
I got a dirty ass right now.
You got a dirty ass right always, now. I actually have a dirty ass.
I've had dirty ass for like fucking 3 days.
I had dirty ass this morning. Took a shit, got in the shower, didn't solve it.
See, I haven't showered. didn't solve it.
Didn't solve it. It was
damn,
weird.
Dude. I haven't
must
showered.
Have beheaded one, dude.
Oh, you beheaded a turd?
To beheaded a turd. His body was still seeping out.
That's the worst when you go to wipe and it turns out you have like a fucking baseball-sized turd in your hand. You're like, oh, God. Just like Kano pulling out the heart in Mortal Kombat. He's just like, oh.
You fucking love Mortal Kombat references. No one fucking gets them. You're always talking about fatalities. No one gets them.
Dude, Mortal Kombat's high. Fuck, that's Americana. That's pure Americana.
That's all fucking Asians.
What, Mortal Kombat?
Yeah.
That's pure Americana.
Oh, God.
Bite your fucking tongue.
That movie, or that fucking video game sucks.
Video games for white heterosexual males and cool black dudes. That's all it's for.
Oh, man. So yeah, that's, yeah.
Last night solidified my stance that for men, specifically men wanting to be famous, I don't like it, dude.
Yeah, it's gay.
The idea, it's literally, thank you. That's like my circling the drain of like, how do I say this about being, it's gay. It's literally it's gay for a dude to want to be famous. That was
what I've been telling our young friend about comedy festivals.
Yeah.
Like I went to that one in Atlanta and it was just networking.
Yeah.
Like that's what they're for, is networking.
Yeah, which is insane.
And then the people they picked to win, they even cast that. Like first off, you got to be a typecast basically to get in.
Yeah.
So either you're a woman, minority, or a pussy white dude.
Yeah.
So maybe Bobby's right. Maybe the reason I got in is because I'm a pussy ass.
No,
white
dude, don't listen to Bobby, dude. Don't listen Bobby's to Bobby. Right. Don't listen to Bobby.
He's out there hardscaping right now with his headphones listening to this. I hope it's cold as fuck right now, Bobby. I hope you're fucking cold, bud. But yeah, it was just, and you would do a show. Or maybe two. And then afterwards, there was always a party, like where everyone just went.
Like a mixer?
Yeah, like a mixer.
Ugh.
And you just talk to other comedians and talk to bookers.
That sounds like a fucking nightmare.
It sucked dick.
There's two people I don't like. Other comedians and people who produce comedy shows. There's like the last two people.
I was talking shit to bookers. I didn't know there were bookers. I was talking to like high people, really high up. I was like, this is fucking gay. I was just blacking out. It was a free beer. I would just go down there and get fucking wasted. And people were like, who the fuck's this guy? I'd be like, yo, you fucking suck, dude. I saw your fucking set. It sucked.
I wish I saw you down there.
Oh, it was terrible, dude. I got down there and I was just miserable. Before I got hammered, I would just stand in the corner every night.
Did you really?
I would talk to like two guys that I knew from before.
Dude, I don't talk. When I go to those mics, I really think I freak people out in New York. Because I go to those mics and I'll like just sit down. They'll like people will be gathered upstairs like talking. And I'll
you
just
would
go
freak
downstairs.
Me out if I saw you just sitting there.
I just sit down and I just like stand by my. I like lump out and charge my phone and just sit there. Just like don't talk to anyone. Then I go up and I'm like, you guys are fucking pussies. Just like, get this guy.
Until I found out this one dude was like with Big Sky. And that's a festival I wanted to get in.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was like, yo, you're the fucking man.
You're the best, dude.
I tried to network with him. I'm so bad at networking.
I can't do it, dude.
I'll walk up and be like, yo, these other guys suck, right? Like, actually, I really like her. She's special. Like, that girl?
And you're like, yeah, definitely. She's great.
The one with the puns? She fucking sucked.
Yeah, dude.
The puns and the glasses and the fucking bangs.
I'm just going to...
Grandma dress.
I'm just banking on getting good enough to wear... Even if it's like I'm fucking 45 or 50, that I can't, dude. I can't go there and schmooze and be like, I might get on How I Met Your Mother. Like, it's disgusting, dude.
Yeah.
It literally disgusts me.
I looked at the lineup for that Bridgetown Festival in Portland. Holy fuck.
Dude, I don't even look at that shit.
Yeah, every once in a while you gotta remind yourself that you're right.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I'm like, am I crazy or are they not booking not gay white dudes?
Yeah.
I'm right.
You got to have a flannel.
Of course, there's some good guys on there. Don't get me wrong.
Of course. No, no.
It's a good festival.
Always.
Comedically.
But, like, you, if, and I would like to do an experiment where I start wearing a flannel and just get, like, a beard and just be like, oh, my God. And it's, like, orange.
Yeah. Just talk about your white guilt.
Yes. Dude, that's all. And everyone up there, it's, like, that's the one joke. It's like, well, you know, I have to. It's like my white privilege. And then they'll try to, like, it's a joke designed to make sure that you know that they understand white privilege and that's a problem and that, like, other people don't, but they're not that person. That's the whole joke. It's insane. Yeah, yeah. It's fucking insanity.
Well, that's, I mean, that's just hack. That's all it is.
It is. It's like
the, so it works for some people, but it is hack. So
it's the 50-year-old guy at the Comedy Zone or the Comedy Cabaret being like, I have Mexican neighbors. They're outside dancing, drinking Coronas. And everyone's they're going to be that dude at the Comedy Zone being oh, my God.
Yeah. Of course.
It's crazy. Meanwhile, dude, we'll just be ascending to heights unimaginable.
We'll be sitting at this fucking poker table.
Oh, definitely. Being like, fucking, probably, you know what sucks?
Not good enough to stay in Philly. We'll be in, like, fucking Scranton.
We'll be in Syracuse.
I'll still be with Caitlin commuting.
We'll be in Syracuse. Like, you know, it's pretty cheap up here. Do you see that new movie? It's fucking dumb.
Oh, speaking of hack premises and shit. Everybody keeps accusing Amy Schumer of stealing things.
Yeah, I watched some of that. That was the one
thing. She's not stealing things. No, dude. Those are just basic premises.
Very basic.
Those are super, like,
yeah,
obvious premises. She's not stealing anything.
No, there was one. What did I watch specifically? It's from David. It was from Dave Chappelle, and it was about guys wanting about to come in different anywhere. Places. It's like, dude, I've seen 90 comedians do that.
Yeah, of course. And it's people that aren't comics that are like, yeah, she's a joke thief. But it's like, no, she's not.
My dude, her bit about blacking out and, like, time travel.
Yeah, I said that before.
Dude, I've had friends try and stand up.
One of those shitty videos that guy posted.
Yeah.
One of them was me saying, I figured out how to time travel.
Dude, literally.
That's it.
Yeah.
That was the joke. I figured out time traveling.
I used to do a time traveling joke about being in, like, a booth at a strip club. I'm like, it's time traveling. You travel 3 minutes and 10 seconds and, like.
Yeah, that's funny.
I mean, it's whatever. It's base humor, dude. I'm above that now. I'm a pure artist. I'm a pure artist now.
I wanted to tell you this. I don't know if I should. Fuck it. The wrestling with the priest joke.
Hit that last night hard.
Phenomenal.
Thank you.
And fuck, there was another one I fucking loved.
I hit that last night hard.
Anyway, yeah, Charles texted me and was like, dude. I was keeping tabs on you, dude.
Keeping tabs on
you.
How's this
half hour doing? And he said it was good. And he said he closed with this joke. He didn't. I don't think he heard it before.
Oh, he didn't.
And I was like, oh, I fucking love that joke,
dude. It was fun.
Anyway, it's Matt saying that if he got raped by a priest, he would be upset that he lost the wrestling match. he'd be upset that he got pinned, not that he got butt fucked.
Yeah, that was fun. I got political last night too.
Did you?
I slammed politics, dude. It was fun.
Nice.
It was cool.
I
finally did it
in Bethlehem. So I was at Steel Stacks with the Tommy Pope.
That lad.
That guy.
It's a sharp looking guy.
Jesus Christ. I actually told him because he gave me a haircut, which you haven't complimented once.
I did. Went outside and said your hair looked nice while he was cutting it. Yeah, I did.
No, that was a different haircut. He gave me another one on Saturday.
When? I didn't notice.
Yeah, of course he did.
It grew back. You have been gone for so long, it grew back.
You don't care.
You've been gone for so long, it moved back.
But we were just talking about how he's hot.
Yeah. Tommy Pope's like classically
hot. He's like, it's not good for comedy. I was like, but you do have the personality of an ugly guy. You know what I mean? He's got the fucking charisma of somebody who has to work for it.
Oh, yeah.
Which is good.
He was fat at some point or something.
Something was weird that he...
Yeah, he got touched maybe.
I think it was his older brothers that touched him, but called him a faggot until he was 18. That'll fucking straighten you out.
Very important.
But and then I was like, I have the personality of, like, a hot guy. Like, I have the arrogance of somebody who doesn't look like me just from playing sports.
Yep, dude.
Like, I was good enough at sports that I actually hooked up with some chicks.
That's all you need.
A guy that looks like me doesn't, you know.
All you need is get asked, like, twice a year during your developmental phases not to turn into a nerd.
Yeah.
Otherwise,
you end up running a comedy festival, you know.
And just watching people do magic.
I decide who's good.
Yep. Dude,
I like her because she's not threatening. Yeah. I like him because he's different.
He's a bully comics is the best now.
Bully comics is sick.
He's a bully comic.
You're a fucking bully, dude.
I'm a fucking dickhead.
The thing is, you're not at all.
Not at all, dude.
Like, I've watched your sets. You don't bully anyone.
I'll fuck around with, like, I'll make fun of people who like comic books and shit. And then it's like, but it's not like.
No, I don't mean like. I mean, like, directly bullying
people.
No,
dude.
Like, every once in a while, I would go to the open mics and be like, hey, so and so, you fucking.
Pay
attention, you fucking suck.
You suck, yeah. See, I won't do that.
I had to stop doing that.
I'll rip on people, but I won't bully.
Because I suck.
No, you don't, dude. Don't get down on yourself. I won't bully. I'll rip on people. But it does. I'll genuinely feel bad if I, like, really. Unless if they have it coming, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
But and there's sometimes if it's good. If I crack on someone and it's funny, that's to me. I'm like, that's not bullying.
Yeah, not at all.
But
just like it was in high school.
Exactly.
If it's funny, it's funny.
It's hilarious, dude. fucking draw a big dick on someone's sports jacket. It's hilarious. Yeah,
turn their book bag inside out.
Classic.
Hit somebody in the face with food at lunch.
I used to carry water. I used to carry water in my mouth through the hallway and just spot someone and go, and spit water all in their face.
I used to hide and scare kids when they came down. And this one fucking douche teacher saw me do it and was like, that's a detention.
What the fuck?
I got fucking detention.
For scaring kids?
For hopping out from behind a wall.
Dude.
Fuck that.
I used to bring antibiotics. Like, if I had a cold or something, like vitamins, I'd bring them to school and put them in a bag. And then I'd find freshmen and be like, yo, bro, you want to take some drugs with me? And they'd be like, oh, I don't. I'm like, come on, dude, do it. I'd try to get them to take antibiotics. Just to see if they do it.
Oh, man. I feel like there was something. Oh, yeah. About the festivals and stuff. Yeah, I don't want these fucking pussy-ass listeners to think that we're wrong and just about bitter that we're not in festivals. You know what I mean?
Dude, I'm like 50%. I applied for one, got in, applied for another, didn't.
Yeah.
No, I'm 1 for 3.
I don't know what the fuck I applied to.
I applied to like 3 or 4, and then I don't know.
But it's weird because you're in a spot where you're like, they're not booking guys that aren't pussies.
It's true, though.
People are just like, are you sure you're not just not getting in because you're not as good?
It's yeah.
Like, yeah.
Positive.
I am. Positive. Yeah.
Positive. I know for a fact I have 45 minutes of stuff that generally works 80% of the time. It's like, pretty sure I can do better than the guy who has maybe 10 minutes of stuff being like, I support lesbians. It's like, cool.
It's like, listen, it's 2017, okay? Mm-hmm. Can we get over it? God.
Dude, it's insane. Well, sanity.
I just wanted to say that. I don't want these bitch-ass listeners to be like...
Let them.
Yeah, true.
You didn't think Caesar had a fucking sea of people being like... True. Meh, meh, meh,
eventually,
backstabbers.
The haters did get him. Literally backstabbers.
They'll get you.
Literally backstabbers. I know. Yeah.
Fucking Brutus, you motherfuckers, dude.
You are all Brutus. It's Pat or fucking Bobby, you fucking Brutus motherfucker, dude. Call me a white pussy, dude.
Stabbed you in the back.
I hope you drop one of those fucking plate blocks or whatever the fuck you're carrying. I've done that before. That job's... I actually like it.
Same here.
It's nice to carry shit.
It is nice. I do like it.
Put it down. Try to arrange it nicely.
I'm just like a big dumb animal. I can't handle any design. It's like, just give me a stone and be like, there. And I'm like...
No, I thought it was fun kind of picking out the design.
I'm bad at that. I live in a Dr. Seuss world, dude. Everything is like... And they're like, make sure this is level. I'm like, oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Level.
I think
sucks,
it is.
Dude.
It's
I used
so
to
fucking...
love using the tamper.
I like I'd the tamper,
tamp
dude.
It down,
Let me
dude.
Tamp it down.
I'll tamp it.
Run it backwards. Run it forwards.
Yep.
Whew. But yeah, that's... I forget my original point.
Well... Anyway, that's good.
Dude, we have fucking like hours.
This is more than enough.
Yes, plenty of time.
Damn, those are some good shout outs, dude.
Good shouties.
Good shout outs.
Hell yeah.
Nicky Oldershaw with a hard shout out. That bull deserves it, dude. He listens.
Hell yeah.
He's another comic, and he's a good comic, and he listens.
Fuck yeah.
He's not a little bitter bitch.
That was my point, dude. Bunch of alpha hating motherfuckers, dude. Yep. Alphas versus betas. Who's going to win?
It is.
Alphas, dude. Betas, have your day. Just wait.
The betas are in complete control.
The betas
somehow. I just, on the way here, listened to Patrice O'Neill talk about this.
Really?
And he was talking about how it's like the school bus when you're growing up. Uh-huh. Like the people in the back of the bus always fucked with the kids in the front.
Naturally.
And now with comedy, the people who control comedy are the kids from the front of the bus.
Yeah.
So they're bitter about that.
It's fucking funny.
And he's got a point.
Well, you got to think, too. You have zero, and myself, we have zero nerd rage inside of us.
Yeah.
Like, there's people who go through life, like, they read, like, Marvel, and they're like, yeah, there aren't bad guys out in the world who take advantage of you, and it's just like, yeah, that happens to us, too, but we're just not fucking dorks about it.
Yeah. I remember that, like, one of the first days I had in high school, my freshman year, I walked into the bathroom, and there was this kid that was a dork.
Yeah.
He was a nerd standing there, and I was like... What's up, man? And he like looked at me and was like, what's up with you? Like, he was just so mean.
Yeah.
The nerd rage, they're all dickheads.
Well, dude, so there's a whole other level to it where, like, if you don't socialize your kid by, I think, like 4 or 5, like, if you send your kid to, like, preschool and, like, for some reason he's doing something weird, and, like, in those years of, like, 5, 6, 7 years old, the other kids decide not to really play with him and include him and stuff.
Yeah.
You're done for, like, you can't learn that again.
Can't get out of that
fucking
nerd rage cycle.
You literally, like, you can't get reacclimated. It's hard.
Yeah.
So there's like a brief window, and if you miss it, you're a nerd. Sorry.
Fuck yeah.
Blame your shitty nerd parents for not acclimating you to people.
Yeah. And then when you don't get into festivals, you can blame the shitty nerd parents again who created the people.
Exactly. It's all a vicious cycle.
When we went in to read something
yeah.
at a very important building.
Uh-huh.
The executives there were all like 25-year-old white chicks. They were the people deciding whether or not it was a good thing. It was insane.
That's terrifying.
I was like, they're going to fucking hate me.
Yeah. But you would be surprised, you know?
I don't know, man.
I mean, yeah, I could see why you'd say that, but I don't know. I mean, any way the wind blows, dude. If they're like, this looks good, then, you know, it all depends.
That's why you got shit like fucking Trevor Noah. Trevor yeah. Noah's special was
garbage.
Fucking insane.
So bad, dude.
It was better than Amy Schumer's, but it was still really Schumer's. Bad. Schumer's is terrible.
It was worse than Noah's?
Yeah. I watched fucking Jim Norton's last night, too.
How was it?
It was good.
I mean,
it's good for like a guy who's up there talking about sucking dicks. It's funny.
Yeah, he's a fucking freak. Chris Tucker had an awful special.
Really?
He came back and tried to do one, and it was just like shitty, unfunny stories from Chris Tucker being like, man. Yeah, dude.
It was like, what's his name? Nick Cannon's. You ever see that special?
I didn't see it, dude.
Oh, the one.
Oh, is he like a white suit?
Yeah, with like a white glove. He has one glove on. It's one of the worst specials I've ever seen. So when those guys were all shitting on it, they were right. They were totally right. Our friends talked shit on Nick Cannon, but it was just the night before he did a black show
yeah.
in Philly. And they posted like, hey, just to remind you guys, Nick Cannon sucks. And we're like, what are you guys, being racist?
Oh, dude, and they got avalanche.
They got fucking crushed.
That was great.
Yeah, but they were totally right. That special is...
dog shit.
Nick Cannon's special is fucking horrific.
He's like, I was never funny.
Amy Schumer's is better than that one. I'll give her that one.
So it goes Nick Cannon as the worst special.
Just Amy Schumer. Off the top of my head. Yeah.
Jesus
actually,
Christ.
No. The worst one is, what's his name?
Who?
Watts. Reggie Watts.
Yes, 100%.
That's easily the worst comedy I've ever seen
in
my life.
Dude, what I fucking don't like and it drives me nuts? Doug Benson's specials. Do you ever watch them?
Yeah, he comes off as like a smarmy, smug little
fucking asshole. It's him on his cell phone being like, let's just check Twitter. And he's like, I'm obviously high right now. And it's just like, it fucking sucks.
Yeah.
I wanted to like it. It was something I literally wanted to like. And I was like, this fucking sucks.
Yeah, he's pretty big.
Huge.
Comedically.
Dude, he does and,
like,
a ton of stuff.
He's actually somehow like super respected by other comics. But it's like,
I love his podcast and shit, dude, but fucking goddamn, I hate his special.
He comes off as this, I have this idea in my head that he's like a smug dickhead, and that's,
I mean,
he never has proved me wrong, ever.
Dude, I watch this guy's specials, because I like saw a couple of his podcasts, like Getting Doug with High, and I'm like, that's kind of funny. And then I saw a special being like, this will be good, and I was like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah.
This is not even, it's just
dude,
this guy
I can't,
reading tweets.
I can't get Reggie Watts off my head right now, dude.
That guy's not a comedian, dude. I watch that. I'm like, this isn't stand-up comedy.
I could have sworn I saw, like, Rolling Stone listed the top 50 comedians, Reggie Watts was on it.
That's people's agents being like, you're going to put him in, right?
Reggie Watts was ahead of Norm Macdonald, who wasn't on the list.
Exactly. So there
was like Aziz, Reggie Watts, all these fucking guys, and Norm Macdonald's not on it.
That's four big management companies being like, all right, we're going to write this list. Time
if
magazine.
You get the chance, listener, fucking Bobby.
Yeah.
Go home, watch Reggie Watts' special on Netflix. Just watch the first 5 minutes where he comes in from the back of the crowd and like crawls over the audience in this weird bit that they're all in on. First off, everyone's sitting in like bean bags. It's the den of the fucking nerd comics.
100%. Like,
anyway,
this guy's great.
If we ever get good, this is going to come back to haunt us.
Whatever.
But I got a feeling...
It doesn't matter. Comedy shelf lives are short. By the time we blow up and become megastars, the comedy shelf lives are like 2-3 years.
You think we're going to sell out the Link?
Dude.
Just like Kev? Just like
Lil Bastard? Definitely like Lil Bastard Kev, dude.
We're going to sell out the Link, dude.
I'm not stopping until I do the Link, dude. I got to do it, man.
You think the Link's going to love that priest butt-fucking joke?
20,000 people with like 1,000-yard stares. Like,
dude,
this guy's
like,
fucking sick.
The Link's like 70,000.
What?
Yeah.
Damn, dude, we gotta get some pyrotechnics on stage.
For sure.
I'll
bring sparklers to the Ravens tonight. I'll stand underneath the stage during your set.
We gotta stop with this joke bullshit, dude. We need pyrotechnics and sick gear.
And you need to launch onto the stage from a trapdoor the way Kev did.
Of course. That, and we need better clothes. We need leather gloves.
Our clothing is horrendous.
Yeah, let's get some. I'm gonna get a leather sweatsuit.
I literally can't afford clothes. So I'm stuck with this Wolf t-shirt and Sears jeans. I just stole a belt from my dad.
Fuck.
All right.
It's a long cast. This is a couple cast. Days you guys miss.
Yeah, suck our dicks.
Kisses.
Praise the Lord, I was born to travel. Feeling like Slash in front of the chapel. I'm lean back with the Les Paul. Shit I smoke is like cholesterol. Spill dressing on the vest at the festival, the best of all.